Okay, David, starting with a question I'm asking all the players. How was it for you to play a game against Garry Kasparov?
Okay, it was a unique opportunity for me, of course, because I hadn't believed that I would ever play against him after he retired in 2005. So I was very surprised that I was invited here, and I am thankful to the organizers and to people who recommended me. Okay, I'm not playing so well, but I'm trying, and sometimes it works out with some luck. So
yeah, he played this Nc3 and g4 line, which used to be topical in his old days. To what extent were you still aware of the old theory?
Okay, I remember there was some game of Grandmaster Anand where he sacrificed a knight, you know, I saw the old games. If we understand old as dating back to 1994, but of course there are much older games. But okay, I know them. But the problem is that I don't even remember the new theory, because my opening repertoire is very broad and I don't work on it so deeply. So I have problems recalling even new theory. And I, frankly speaking, I was not very much aware of this bishop e3. I knew there was some line with knight c6, dc5. Knight e5, and that it was dangerous for black, but okay, when you don't know it and your opponent is prepared, you cannot play like this. But okay, what I played was even worse, of course.
Yeah, you got in a very bad ending with that bishop on g6. Yeah. What was going through your mind? Just hang on and hope for the best?
You know, when I was young, my openings were not really good, so I needed to play tenaciously. I needed to search for the most stubborn defense since my very childhood, because it has always been my problem, and so I got used to playing poor positions. Of course, on this level, it usually doesn't help even if you defend well, because the opponents are just too strong. But okay, it's just a rapid chess and blitz, and in rapid chess, even the strongest players might make mistakes.
And I think you told my colleague Mike that you saw this queen takes c6 quite ahead of time.
Okay, when I was before white played king c5, I calculated it up to bishop c8, rook takes c8, rook e8 check, and I had a feeling that maybe I was losing, but I couldn't find anything else. But okay, I was lucky. But okay, when you continue searching for some defensive possibilities, you are sometimes successful. It's just a statistical phenomenon.
Yeah, and I just watched your last game. It started like a equal drawish rook end game, became quite a fascinating end game. You must have enjoyed that game as well.
Yes, but the end game was hard for me because I was a pawn down, and I was under pressure. I missed something, and I was afraid it could have been lost. I saw an interesting option for white, but ironically, it was lost. In a completely different moment, it was a tough game, but in the end I got lucky. So okay, I'm happy to have scored some points finally.
Okay, and last question: how do you feel going into the blitz? Do you like playing blitz? Do you think you can do as well, or maybe even better than in the rapid?
I hope I can do slightly better than in rapid, because my first day was really not good here. And okay, I don't know. Sometimes I can play blitz quite well, sometimes really badly. It just depends on my momentary form. It's hard to predict anything.
Okay, thanks a lot and good luck tomorrow. Okay.